You're listening to the 10-Minute Podcast Challenge that'll prove every place is the same. Welcome your host, the irreverent, the cosmopolitan, the wicked, Daniela Vlaskalic.
Hello, and welcome to Every Place Is The Same. I am thrilled to welcome my guest, Kerry Griffin.
Hello.
Hi, Kerry. How are you?
I'm doing well, thank you. Thanks
Excellent.
For having me.
Couldn't be happier. Now, Kerry,
yes.
You have spent some time in Tokyo,
I
Japan.
Have. Yes.
Is that correct?
That is correct.
Tell me about that.
It was very interesting. It's a whole different world. And Tokyo is a huge city. Like, it feels like New York on steroids. You go to any, you can go to one place and be like, oh, this is the Times Square of Tokyo. This is the huge downtown. Then you hop on the subway, go five stops later. Oh, here's another one. Everywhere is just feels like craziness, crazy busy.
Big city. We got it.
Yep.
Okay, you've also spent some time in Amsterdam.
Yes.
In the Netherlands.
Yes.
Tell me about that.
Amsterdam, I love the people, the culture, the whole atmosphere. It's a beautiful city. You got canals. You've got, marijuana and hash cafes if you're into that sort of thing. It's got everything. It's beautiful.
Now, Kerry, would you say that Tokyo, Japan, and Amsterdam in the Netherlands are the same?
No. I would say they're quite different. Tokyo seems much more dense and hustly-bustly. Amsterdam's more relaxed and chill. Yeah.
Fascinating.
Yeah.
Well, today on Every Place Is The Same, we are going to prove that Tokyo, Japan, and Amsterdam in the Netherlands are the same.
All right. I'm game.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Excellent. Now, how much do you know about the 12th century?
I would say... not a lot, though I did just watch a movie about Genghis Khan, and he, I believe, lived in the 12th century, so I got that going for me.
Yes, he did. Well, Tokyo and Amsterdam also got their start in the 12th century. They were both small fishing villages.
Oh, okay, fair enough. Yep, I can't argue with that.
Why would they be fishing villages, do you think?
I suppose because they're both near water. They both have a harbor Amsterdam, I don't even know, is Amsterdam on, Amsterdam's not right on the ocean, but it's got connections to it. So yes, they're on water. That makes
sense. Do you have a favorite fish?
Oh, wow. I like sharks. Does that count as a fish? Shark's a fish.
I hope you didn't eat any shark, Kerry. You know, that shark finning is devastating to the shark population.
I completely agree. No, I only like sharks to look at. I haven't eaten a shark before.
I'm happy to hear that.
Thank you.
Now, fish is a very popular dish in both of these places.
Yes, yes it is.
Tell me about that.
Well, Tokyo, I mean, the big thing that comes to mind in Japan is sushi, of course. So I like sushi. The sushi in Japan is, you know, mwah. In Amsterdam, I don't think they're big on sushi there, but there is seafood. I'm trying to think of what their big fish they eat is. But it
raw
is.
Herring.
Herring,
Kerry.
There you go.
Raw
Thank
herring.
You. See, I didn't sample the raw herring.
Really?
No.
Why not?
I don't know. It didn't appeal to me.
So you'll eat sushi,
exactly.
But you won't try raw herring.
No, yeah, that makes sense. Yes. They're different. They're prepared differently.
Are they?
I think so. That's not based on any firsthand knowledge.
Raw is raw.
I suppose, yes, you're right. Raw is raw.
What other foods did you enjoy in Tokyo?
I did go to like a Korean barbecue, even though it's in Tokyo. Or what do they call it when they cook right on the surface there? Is that a Korean barbecue? Anyways, a teppanyaki, that's the word I'm looking for, where they throw their knives in the air and stuff like that. And
that's
cook right
not
on
Korean at all.
No, it's Japanese. You're right. Korea's different. Korea's not the same, but that's a whole other show.
Yes, listen to Amanda Barker's episode to find out more about Korea.
So, yes, there was beef and steak and various, mostly cow products now that I think of it. But, yeah, cooked right there. That was delicious.
Was there grilled food in Amsterdam?
I don't remember any specifically, but I can't deny that they probably do have grilled food there.
What other foods did you enjoy in Amsterdam?
Amsterdam, I think of, I remember a lot of like meats and cheeses and that kind of thing, almost like a charcuterie board type stuff. I remember sweets in Amsterdam. They have a lot of like waffly things and chocolatey things.
Did
and
you
that
try
sort of
a Dutch pancake by any chance?
I don't think I did. I don't know what a Dutch pancake is. It sounds naughty.
A Dutch pancake is a very thin pancake that can be either sweet or savory.
Oh, it's like a crepe, I have to assume.
No, it's a Dutch pancake.
Fair enough.
Now, Japan has a very interesting and traditional savory pancake as well.
I did not know that. I don't remember many sweets in Japan.
Okonomiyaki.
Okonomiyaki?
Yes.
Ah. Is that like a crepe?
No, Kerry. It's an okonomiyaki, a Japanese pancake, not a crepe.
Hmm. I understand.
Did you spend any time in the red light district?
I did walk through it one night, yes.
In which city?
In Amsterdam. Oh, and well, in Tokyo, it's... Yes, no, you're right. I did walk through a red light district in Tokyo, too. You're correct.
Ah, so you spent time in the red light district in both cities.
Spent time sounds a little more extreme than I'd like. I walked through them, yes.
Now, the red light district is quite popular in both places for tourists to walk through. Is that correct?
Sure, and do more than walk through, I suppose, yes.
Why is that?
Well, there's sites. They're different. There's, of course, the red light districts are associated with sex and prostitution and things of that sort. I wasn't looking for that. I was just curious about what the atmosphere was like.
And what was it like?
It was interesting. In Amsterdam, I remember walking down the street, and in each window you would see the sex worker, and there was every type you could imagine. Tall, short, slim, old, young, big, small, whatever your taste, you name it, your interest was there. There were probably male ones, too. I don't even know. In Tokyo, I remember, they're much more aggressive in the sense, not the sex workers themselves, but you would walk through the street. Things weren't on display in the window, but men would be aggressively like, hey, you want this, you want that, come with me, come with me, come with me. They would be like pushing you to go into whatever establishment for various things.
So in either place, there's a variety of choice.
Yes, I would agree.
Did you feel safe in Amsterdam?
Yes, I felt safe in Amsterdam, yes.
It's the sixth safest city in the world.
I did not know that.
Did you feel safe in Tokyo?
I did, for the most part, feel safe in Tokyo, yes.
It is also considered one of the safest cities in the world.
They are both very safe.
Kerry, what is your preferred choice of transportation?
Transportation? I would go with driving. I'm a driver. I drive around the city here.
Would you drive in Tokyo?
Whew. I guess I would. I didn't while I was there.
Would you drive in Amsterdam?
No, I would be more inclined to ride a bike. There are big bikers there in Amsterdam.
They are. Tokyo is also a cycling nation.
Oh.
Actually, Japan is.
I wasn't as aware of that. I guess there's so many people in general, I don't remember the bikes standing out. In Amsterdam, I remember tons of bikes everywhere.
Apparently, in Japan, 53% of people cycle.
That's a lot.
That's an enormous amount of people.
How many?
There's 38 million people in the Tokyo GTA alone.
So 53% of that would be, you know, 18, 19 million or something.
That's a lot of bikes.
That is a lot of bikes.
Do you think you'd look good in bike shorts?
Yes, I feel confident about my appearance in bike shorts, though I have skinny legs, but I think that's okay.
What were one of your favorite things to do in Amsterdam?
One of my favorite things to do while I was there would be to go to a cafe and partake of some marijuana and then just wander the streets and look at the sights. It's a beautiful city to wander by the canals and look at the architecture and that sort of thing.
What about in Tokyo?
In Tokyo? Well, I didn't smoke anything in Tokyo, but certainly walking around to see the areas was a wonderful thing, or just to hop on the train. There are many, many trains. Hop on a train and get out at some random place I didn't know and explore a little bit.
They have canals in Tokyo as well.
Oh, I honestly didn't think they did. I don't remember canals, but I'll take your word for it.
They have the Sumida River Cruise.
Oh, I didn't do any cruising there. I didn't go on any bodies of water there.
That's too bad.
It really is. I guess I missed the canal section of Tokyo.
Well, we can't do it all, Kerry.
No, there's only so much time in the day.
Talk to me about beer.
Whoa, beer? I'm a beer fan. I like beer. I don't drink too much beer. I've switched more to whiskeys or wines lately in my older age, but I do like a beer. Lately, I'd like a stout beer, like a Guinness or something.
We can't drink it all, Kerry.
No, that would be very unhealthy.
Beer, you can find and drink anywhere.
Oh, yes, that's very true.
In Tokyo, mm-hmm. and in Amsterdam.
I had beers in both places, yes.
Did you drink them in parks?
Oh, I don't think I did. No, I only drank them in establishments.
Well, it's quite a popular thing to have a beer in a park.
Oh.
In Tokyo.
That's good to know.
And in Amsterdam.
Oh, I certainly saw people drinking, yes, in both cities. It's true. And I remember in Tokyo, for sure, you could even get beer at vending machines.
And there you go.
Mm-hmm.
If you're intrigued by places that were founded in the 12th century, if you love raw fish, sushi, or herring, if you really are in the mood for a Dutch pancake or an okonomiyaki, not a crepe. If you're just in the mood for a safe place to stroll or ride a bike or just feel like exploring the red light district, then I think, Kerry, you helped prove that Tokyo, Japan and Amsterdam in the Netherlands are the same.
I am beginning to wonder if I just went to the same place twice. I'm not certain that I saw two different cities.
Maybe you did, Kerry. Maybe you did.
You just listened to Every Place is the Same, hosted by Daniela Vlaskalic and directed by Marco Timpano. Leave us a 5-star review on iTunes, Stitcher, or wherever you listen. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram or join our Patreon page. Until the next time, enjoy your travels.